Now, the trade price, the recommended retail price is $179.99 for a Nintendo Wii. And obviously, you know, it, I don't know what a dealer price for it would be, but let's say it was $140, just for example. So they might make £40 on it. I don't know how realistic that is. But let's say, for example, it was $140 or maybe even $150, $160. Well, it won't be $160. So let's say it was $150. So that the dealer, instead of now earning about £30 on it, would be earning about a tenner on it, because they are being expected to swallow the increase without passing it on to the consumer. I'm not so sure that some people won't start selling it for more, because at the moment Nintendo can sell as many of the Nintendo Wiis as they can actually manufacture. You know, the Nintendo Wii pops up somewhere and it disappears. You know, it goes on Amazon, all the websites report the fact that Amazon's back in stock of the Nintendo Wii, and then suddenly it disappears again. So I'm not at all certain that people won't use it as an excuse to increase the price. So if you want a Nintendo Wii, my suggestion is, if you can find it, go out and buy one right now. And, you know, don't wait for the price to increase. I've noticed this happening a lot. I looked at some computer monitors yesterday, and I noticed the price on it, and then it went up £11 overnight. And that's happening quite a lot now. So if you want a Nintendo Wii, here's a heads up. I would go out and get one now, even though they're not officially saying the price will go up. I think it might. We go now to Victor on line one. Victor, welcome to the Gadget Detective Show.
Hello, Fevzi. How are you?
I'm good, thank you, Victor. Now, I heard you on Chris Reardon's program.
You did, but I was pretending to be Peter Chapman.
Peter Chapman?
Yes, I tried to do an English accent, but it didn't work very well.
Ah, I see. Well, wasn't
because Peter Chapman had called in pretending to be Gary and Luton, I wanted to keep the chain going, It was a piece of fun. I didn't mean anything by it.
No, I was just jealous, you know, when I hear my caller somewhere. I mean, I thought we had something here, Victor, and, you know, I didn't realize.
Well, I couldn't possibly. I couldn't. I was actually a little bit mean to Chris, because I said that that his a shorter version suggested by his friend was much better than the version which he's got on the YouTube.
I know. I heard you say that, and I thought, that's not the Victor I know. Okay, because the Victor I know is tender and he's loving, and I just didn't really believe that was you. I thought that's probably that Peter Chapman guy again.
Well, I was pretending to be him.
Yeah.
So,
who was the guy who shot? Sorry, this is not a competition question, but who was the guy who shot John Lennon?
The guy who shot John Lennon?
Was it? It wasn't Peter Chapman.
I think it wasn't Sue Ellen, was it?
No. We're talking about reality, not a soap opera.
No, I know, it's Ray Krebs.
Matt, can you Google this for me?
Well, I'm not in front of the PC because I got very bad mobile phone connection where my PC is. I had to come over to the window. But I could Google maybe later on.
Okay, no problem. But, okay, I was just curious about that. But not to worry. Victor, what can I do you for?
Well, first I just want to say that you're very right to say that if you want a V, you shouldn't wait. Because you have to spend a penny, and you might end up spending a pretty penny, but that's not really what I wanted to ask
you. Okay, well, thank you for the voter support.
Yes, I wanted to. What I didn't want to ask you, because I come to that later. What I wanted to just say is your price tonight is really great. As you know, you converted me to using Dragon, and I'm using Dragon every single day. I've used Dragon today for a lot of different applications. It works like a charm.
Yes, and what do you specifically, do you use it mainly for dictation, or do you also use it to browse the internet and navigate your Windows desktop?
I don't use it so much for the second use, because I find that it's just as fast, like you said as well, you can't do everything just with voice. You have to mix so that you can keep your stamina at the workstation for longer. So these are the things which I'm doing by hand.
Yes.
And then when I got a big piece of dictation, I might even close my eyes and concentrate, like in the Carpenter's song, and it comes out a lot better what I'm saying too, and they're really good, and it just does it, and then I can open my eyes, he's already done the whole thing, just go through and correct it, you know? It's a really wonderful way of working.
It is good. Do you know, I've just had this thought, because you mentioned the Carpenters, and that was, what was it, calling occupants of interplanetary craft, wasn't it?
Interplanetary craft.
Most extraordinary craft. Yeah, I remember. What would happen if you sang at your Dragon, naturally speaking, software? Would it understand?
I haven't tried it.
Do you know, why don't we try it? As an experiment, have you got your Dragon up and running at the moment, I assume?
Well, it's on my work machine. I need another copy for my home machine, okay. Which is why I enter your competition today, actually.
Victor, here is your homework, then. Your homework for this week is I want you to sing to your Dragon. Sounds like a vague drug reference, but I promise you.
It sounds like Harry Potter, actually.
I want you to sing to your Dragon.
I want to make sure that J.K. Rowling doesn't end up suing you for the idea or something, saying it comes from one of her books.
Well, I don't know. I came up with Quidditch first, but what can you do? I want you to sing to your Dragon, and next week I want you to tell me if it had any idea at all what it was saying, and perhaps sing to it the line from a famous song, and then tell me what text it came up with in response.
Okay, I will do this.
The lyrics of maybe a Beatles song or something well known, so that we'll all know what the lyrics should have been. And then
I might even do the Carpenter's song, you know, bit that we spoke to about
okay.
a second ago. But let me come to my question, because
okay. Oh, there is a question. Okay, good.
There is a question. Everybody will say I'm hogging you tonight, but, you know, if they don't come on, it's their lookout. They're doing what this Oscar called backsliding. So... they're not coming on, and I'm on. So I will give you the question that
okay,
I have.
Okay, Victor. Right.
I need a new camera.
Yes.
And I want to have camera which not only make a very nice film,
yes.
but also, and this is what you never find in the reviews, in the newspapers or the websites, I like a camera what's got very good audio.
Very good audio. Mm.
Yes, I like the microphone to be good. And I'm not talking about a video camera, I'm talking about the camera which is like a compact digital camera.
Yes.
Which takes the digital films, stills, mm-hmm. and then also has the function taking like an AV or what have you.
Where you can attach a video clip to it. Are you talking about attaching audio clips to still images, or are you talking about the sound on video?
The sound on video.
Okay, fine. Look... Let me say this to you. Still cameras don't have great microphones on them, okay, because they are primarily still cameras and not camcorders. Even camcorders that, you know, even prosumer camcorders, their microphones are obviously better, but they're still not great. The feature that they have that makes them suitable for high-quality audio is that they have microphone input sockets. And I don't remember seeing a still camera with microphone input sockets. Now, if anyone's got one or seen one, then they can correct me, but I don't recall having seen one.
I never had one. I've got Panasonic now, and I had yeah. Fuji FinePix before, which was very nice. Yeah. Much better audio than my Panasonic.
The reason why it's better to actually plug a microphone in is because then you can get the microphone much closer to the source of the sound. Okay, this is why it's a problem. This is also why when you get a webcam with a built-in microphone, the sound is often very poor because the microphone is too far away. The right mm-hmm. place. That's why people, you know, when you see them on television, they wear a tie clip microphone to put it, you know, just clipped on near the tie to get it very close to their mouth, or they wear a headset.
Yeah.
Or alternatively, if they might have a boom operator, which is a guy with a big broom handle with a microphone just out of shot. So the idea is that. Now, having said all that, there is a Canon SX1 IS camera. It's not a small camera, but I'll tell you two things about that camera. First of all, it is equally good at taking still pictures as it is at taking video. It shoots video in high definition. And it shoots it as well as an average consumer high definition camcorder. And it's
can you zoom and video at the same time?
It's a very good question. I believe, don't quote me. I think you can. I had one of these for a couple of weeks, and I actually now can't remember if it had that facility. Generally, they don't like to do it because of the motor noise, but I think you can. All right, let me just put it as
strongly as that. Could you remind again one time more the name of this Canon?
It's a SX1, Sierra X-Ray 1, IS. IS stands for image stabilization, okay, because it's got optical image stabilization. Now, that microphone...
It's like sexy one.
Yeah, SX1 IS. Be careful, because there's an SX10, which is not as good. Okay.
So I have to think of the sexy one and not the sexy 10.
Yeah, you think of the sexy one and that's it. Now, that camera... actually has two microphones on it. So with the two microphones, they actually claim to be able to produce surround sound. Now, it doesn't produce great surround sound, but obviously they've given a bit of extra time and effort to that camera. So check out the SX1.
And it's still a compact.
It's not very compact. You're not going to get good sound out of a compact camera. I mean...
Okay, but it's technically speaking in the compact family, yes?
No, it's not. It's bigger.
Is it a single...
It's not an SLR, but it's more similar to a small SLR than it is to a small compact.
I'm liking the sound of it. Have you got the price of it?
I think it was about 400.
Pounds?
Yes. Mm. Check it out.
Okay, well, pound is not too expensive right now, so maybe you know where I should buy?
Victor, I'm going to have to love you and leave you there because I'm being asked very politely to move on, and we go now to... But thank you for your call. I do appreciate it. We go to Ross now on line two.
Hello, Fuzzy. Evening. How are you?
I'm good, thanks. Sorry to keep you waiting. How are you?
That's all right. No problem. No, I'm brilliant, thanks. I've just got a couple of quick questions for you.
Go ahead, please.
I've had a Creative Zen MP3 player, the 30 gigabyte one, for about a good 5 or 6 years now.
Right. Good machine, isn't it?
Oh, they're very good. I mean, they've been faultless up until now. I mean, absolutely brilliant. The best couple of £100 I've ever spent. But the battery isn't keeping the charge anymore.
No, it won't.
I know this is going to happen sooner or later, so I'm not too bothered, but would you suggest buying the original battery? And I'm not actually sure if Creative still makes the battery.
Messages through the vast unknown. Please close your eyes, concentrate with every thought you see. Upon the recitation, we're about to see. Calling occupants of interplanetary craft. Calling occupants of interplanetary most extraordinary craft. Calling occupants of interplanetary craft. Calling occupants of interplanetary most extraordinary. You've been observing ours, and we'd like to make a contract with you. We are your friends. Calling occupants of interplanetary Alpha Emissary. And please come in peace, we beseech you. Others may never survive. Interstellar policeman, won't you give us a sign? Give us a sign that we've reached you. Declare your contract.